Hi everyone, welcome to today's video. Don't mind this, it is just a little accessory that I have for today's video. So I really want to talk about my experience at UCLA, particularly with UCLA engineering. I have lots of things to cover, so let's go ahead and get started. Okay, I'm not gonna wear this the whole video, so I'll just take it off for now. I went to UCLA. I graduated last year in a degree of electrical engineering, and I am here to tell you all about it. I really want to talk about my experience, especially as a transfer student, and everything that I learned in my journey to get this piece of paper. Okay, so where should we start? Why did I choose UCLA? Originally, when I was applying for schools, I had it in my mind that I really wanted to go to Berkeley. It was my childhood dream to go to UC Berkeley. I had told everyone far and wide for a lot of my life that Berkeley was the school I wanted to go to. However, when application season came around and I actually started doing my research more in depth, and after I got my acceptances to both UCLA and UC Berkeley, I decided to go take a trip to both schools. My trip to UC Berkeley was not great. I don't know, I just kind of felt like I wouldn't be happy there. And really, this is a big, big personal reason. You know, I'm a person that is just used to being at home with family. So having family close to me meant a lot to me. My family is from San Diego, so moving somewhere to the Bay Area, I just started to feel so much more real. And then I believe when I visited, it was about finals week for them. So just seeing the stress that everyone was under and the atmosphere of the school, imagining myself in that situation and not really having the support of my family and not being able to just make the quick drive down to visit them if I ever needed anything, I really just didn't feel like it would be a great choice for me. And secondly, like I mentioned, I was a transfer student. When I went to visit Berkeley, they didn't really have an event for transfer students, like an open house for transfer students when I was admitted. They had something like it, but it wasn't really an official open house for transfer students. And if there was, I was never notified about it. I just didn't really feel welcomed by the school like I did with UCLA. So now let's talk about UCLA. UCLA 100% made me feel so, so welcome from the very beginning. We had an open house for transfer students where we got to specifically meet and talk to advisors, different professors, different people that are involved in the actual School of Engineering, and then even smaller than that with your actual major. And also on top of all this, UCLA has a program called SEED. SEED was an amazing program, and me being a first generation immigrant student and also a woman of color in engineering, I was really grateful for this program because I, you know, finally felt like I had a group of people that were sort of in the same boat as me, people who had similar experiences growing up, who are also first generation, who are also, you know, battling with a lot of external factors when it comes to coming to school and trying to break those generational cycles. So all of that really just combined, and I felt so welcome there. I felt happy when I was on campus. The campus is not only beautiful, but it also just has this warmth to it. And so I decided, even though I had said for a very large part of my life that I wanted to go to Berkeley, that I was going to go to UCLA. But it wasn't necessarily a easy transition for me. I actually struggled quite a bit. When I transferred, I came from a semester school. the school that I went to was in San Diego, and you know, back in high school it was semesters, my community college was semesters. So switching over to a school that is of, you know, very high academic rigor, such as UCLA, and then on top of that, having to transition onto the quarter system, which is only 10 weeks, it was very, very difficult. I would say it's one of the most difficult things I had to do in my academic journey. I remember the first couple classes that I took were just, I was struggling so much. And not only that, but it also kind of felt like everyone already knew each other. Everyone already had their friend groups and they had their study groups. So coming in as a transfer student can be a little bit difficult in that way, where you are not only struggling to adapt to this new environment that you're in, you're also struggling to adapt to a new social environment. Trying to break into different study groups that have been long established, perhaps since those students were freshmen. So it was definitely a lot of things to have to deal with all at once. It can be really overwhelming. So having a support group that you can rely on from the beginning, trying to find that and trying to foster that, is extremely important. I'm very grateful, like I said, for Seed, because in Seed, I was able to meet other transfer students and other students that were in my same, junior level that came in when they were freshmen. So they're a little bit more experienced about the way that it works. So that was really, really helpful for me. But they weren't always in my classes. So sometimes I did have to step a little bit out of my comfort zone and talk to other people who I, you know, clearly didn't know, and try to form these study groups for myself. Once I started to do that and I started to break out of my shell a little bit and feel a little more comfortable with the environment and with the rigor of the course load, then I really started to feel like, you know, I was finally getting the hang of it, but it did take a while. Now, something else I want to mention is UCLA Engineering, there are a lot of classes that you need to take. And if you actually do the math for all of the classes that you need to take with a basic full course load of, you know, your 12 units, it is very likely that you're not going to finish in 4 years. Because there are just so many classes that you need to take. So I did end up taking 3 years. So I transferred in and then I did 3 years. And it's also very common for people who come in as freshmen to take 5 years. So this is something that I actually really recommend that you consider if you are coming in new to UCLA. I think that it was very important for me to take the 3 years instead of the two for a lot of different reasons. One of them being, you know, it's a period of transition and it's already going to be difficult to try to get settled in. And then on top of that, trying to manage things like internships, which are very important if you're an engineering student, clubs, a social life, a, you know, personal life of any sort with your academics. So I 100% recommend that you consider adding on that extra year if your finances allow it. Now, let's talk about how I paid for school. I had two scholarships that helped me pay for my education. One of them was the Jack Kent Cook Scholarship. I had the undergraduate transfer scholarship, and this helped me pay for, the scholarship covers up to $40,000 a year, but it's not limited to tuition. You can also apply it towards living expenses like rent and bills. And then on top of that, I was also a UCLA Regent Scholar, which is amazing, and I am really grateful for that. So I was able to graduate completely debt-free. Don't be scared of applying to those really big name scholarships. I was being discouraged at the time from applying to the Jack Kent Cook Scholarship. You know, I was told things like only 80 people in the whole country get it. It's really not worth the time. It's not worth investing yourself into this. It's very rare. But I was selected and it was such an amazing thing. And, you know, I was able to graduate without any debt at all whatsoever. I had my tuition covered, I had my rent covered, I had my books covered, they even gave me a laptop. So apply to those opportunities, even if you feel like, you know, you won't get it or like it's very, very unlikely. I went for it and I got it. So absolutely recommend. So the last thing that I want to talk about is, well, two things. One, the environment. What is it actually like to be at UCLA? And two, the academics, because that is a very important part. So number one, the environment. UCLA is such a beautiful campus and it also feels so open. But engineering is very time consuming. So definitely don't spread yourself too thin. There are so many different clubs and organizations and classes that you can take outside of your academics. So it can be easy to try to do it all. So definitely be careful when it comes to that. Absolutely get involved with the campus because there's anything that you can imagine at UCLA. And there are so many different groups just ready to welcome you in. But it's really important that you make sure that you take care of your academics first. Because as engineers, you already know you are not going to be left with much time. And lastly, the academics. What do I say about this? Okay, so as we know, UCLA is a research institution. So it is very, very well known for its research labs, which are absolutely amazing. Especially if you're considering grad school, it is really important that you start getting involved with research opportunities as an undergrad. I was able to be part of a research lab and it was a really great experience. However, I always knew that I wanted to go into industry. So I think that there is a big disconnect right now with students wanting to do industry afterward and the instruction that we are receiving, not in a bad way, but it is very theoretical and very research focused. Everything that we're learning, you know, it's extreme theory and huge amounts of math, which is awesome. I love math and it's beautiful, but I do wish there was also a little bit more of that applied component of, you know, for example, designing your own circuit. You learn how to solve the equations and solve for the different things in a circuit that is being presented to you, but you're not really taught how to design one yourself for a specific function, how to protect it from different cases like overvoltage or things like that. You're also not really taught how to use professional lab equipment. So those are some of the things that I wish were a little bit more common in electrical engineering at UCLA. But again, you know, having that big research background does help because anything that gets thrown into you later on, it's very easy for you to figure it out and learn new things. The rigor at UCLA is very well known. It is an extremely rigorous program. You are going to learn so much. You're going to learn things that you didn't even think you were capable of learning. You know, you're going to write math equations that you never imagined you would be able to solve. And it's such a beautiful thing. However, because UCLA is a research institution, a lot of the professors are researchers first and lecturers second. So that means that you really have to be careful with which professors you are choosing for your classes, because some of them, you know, research is their priority and lecturing is just not. And for me, it's really important to have a professor who is really passionate about teaching us and not so much a professor who is just somebody, you know, trying to get a side job done, which unfortunately does happen. However, this happens at many, many universities. There are resources like Bruin Walk where you can go and research your professors, look at the ratings. This is kind of like Rate My Professor, but for UCLA, and make a plan for yourself. I also would really like to recommend that you speak with the current students in the program and really get to know who the professors are, who the ones that are worth taking are, and who are the ones that you should avoid. So overall, I would say that while I was there, I experienced some of the, you know, darkest times of my life in terms of just how overwhelmed I felt, how stressed I felt, how overworked burned out, under every kind of pressure you can imagine. But now looking back, it also made me such a strong person. And it made me a person who is now essentially capable of overcoming any challenge in the workplace. That is why I now do the work that I do in trying to talk to all of you guys and make sure that you know exactly how to navigate those situations, because it really was a lot of trial and error for me. But if I can avoid that for somebody else, then by all means, I am going to do it. So that concludes this video. There are so many more things that I could talk about. If you have any questions, make sure you leave them down in the comment section. I would love to answer them. If you are planning on going to UCLA, are already going to UCLA, or just really want to go to UCLA, let me know. And thank you so much for watching my video.